That Levi Brown might have been the biggest surprise today. Were you surprised actually that you had to make that cut so early? In other words, were you surprised at how sincere he did?
It was a tough cut for me because I really, really like Levi Brown. Last year, you know, he's a guy that we brought in, and I thought maybe he can battle for the two job. And, you know, I think he did a decent job in this last preseason game. Tino did some good things also, but, you know, we weren't going to keep four quarterbacks, and, you know, it was a tough decision, but we had to move forward.
Do you just feel Tino's ceiling maybe higher right now?
Well, you know, like I said, he had a good game. And really, I think for Tino, this second game, I really see exactly where he is. You know, maybe he'll get a little bit more time. But, you know, as far as his ceiling, I think both of them are pretty good. I just think right now he looked a little bit better with what we were doing than Levi did at the time.
When you went back and forth between the two of them in the fourth quarter, was the competition on at that point?
You know what? No, I tell you, that was just the way that we had it set, you know, as far as the rotation. And, you know, you can see through practice, but they both have good arms. They both throw good footballs. But at the end of the day, you know, like I said, I really like Levi, and I hope he gets picked up somewhere. But, you know, at the end of the day, we were only going to keep three, not four. And Tino looked like he's a little ahead of the curve at this time.
Is it tougher to release a guy who's been in your system for years?
Yeah, it's always tough. You know, even when we were making out the times, you know, I said, hey, because the management did most of the guys. I said, well, let me talk to Levi for a second, you know, because he's a guy that, like I said, we brought him in, and you form a relationship with him. And me as a coach, you know, I know that they'll all be released or something at one point in time, but I just wanted to make sure he was okay, and told him that if he needed help in any way, we would try to help him.
What has Tino showed you from start to finish?
Well, I mean, first of all, you know, there's a lot of press on Tino. His dad's a football coach, and he's been doing it forever, so he understands what it's like to be in the pros. He's been around it his whole life, you know, in top college programs, so he's very poised. He's very comfortable, and I think he's a very smart kid when it comes to learning the playbook, and like I said, he's able to execute. Two biggest things we wanted to see out this last game was communication and execution, and he did them.
Kenny Rowe, was it just the younger guys like Will Davis passing him by?
Yeah, you know, Kenny's a guy that's been here a couple of times, and, you know, he's made some good plays, but then you have the Will Davis and those guys. They show some good things also. And, you know, it was one of those things to where, you know, you try to project how good they'll be. That's where the second preseason game comes from. But, you know, we've seen Kenny Rowe over a couple of years. It was, another decision that's, you know, tough because you know these guys and you've given them second chances. But at the end of the day, we thought we had some good young guys that we had to make some room for to see.
Do you have an idea how the kicking game will play out after that first preseason game?
Oh, it's going to be even worse after this preseason game because now all three are going to kick this week. So that's going to be Ricky, it's going to be Milo, and it's also going to be McKnight. So, you know, we'll try to rotate their time to see exactly how it's going to shake down. But, you know, I'm pleased to watch that one. That's one I'm going to look forward to.
Did McKnight take the lead, you think, in that competition because he was perfect and Milo wasn't?
Well, you know, there was one of those to where, you know, if I can think about it, I think Milo's were his misses, if I'm not mistaken, were they 49, 51, something like that. And it'll be the same thing in this game. I want to see which kicker can give me a 48-yard field goal. So, you know, that's what I want to do. I don't think Brody had those. So I think he was like 30, 35, which should be chip shots. So I want to make sure that, you know, the kicker that's on the roster can give us those deep field goals. So we'll see that this Thursday.
I'm going to leave us. Turner, I thought he looked pretty good.
You know what? He looked pretty good all until he made that mistake with the ball. He was one of those to where, you know, I think we're not as deep as we'd like to be. He did make some good he did make some good returns. Excuse me. But you have Jock there, you know, Diamond fill in. You got Weston Dressler, and we got to get room to be able to see a couple more guys. You know, like Harper, I think will also do returns this week. So there's a couple of guys we just want to open up and see, and also whoever that returner is, if it's not going to be Jock, he'll have to play in the offense. So, you know, we got to make sure that those guys can play in the offense and be able to return.
With Milo on the sideline, you went over. How do you handle some coaches say leave him alone, let him go through it. Are you more someone who wants to pat him on the back and give him some confidence?
The thing I told Milo is, I was like, you see those two uprights? He's like, yeah. I said, put the ball between them. it's just that simple. You know, he's a kicker, and he just has to get his mindset ready. He can do the job. He's done it numerous times, and for whatever reason, he missed those. But, you know, I don't get him riled up, you know, because they have a pretty tough job. But at the end of the day, it's just going to make it real simple for them. Do your job and make sure that you execute.
Is there any more concern considering last year he was replaced by Sandro because he was inconsistent at the place kicking?
Well, you know, we have three kickers. And, you know, like I said, the best man will win the field goal job. And hopefully, you know, it's one of the three and we don't have to bring another one in. But I think those guys can get it done. There's some inconsistency last year, and I think he has to make sure that he strives to make sure there's not any coming up in this upcoming game.
Did he endorse you the backup running back now?
Well, as for roster, when it comes to preseason, you know, I can't tell you how that goes as far as that. He still needs to do some things during the game to show us something. Like I said, we just had to get down to a certain number. So there's still some guys that, you know, still need to do some showing. You know, there are no locks with the team. Right now, it's just the first round of cuts, and some guys still need to show up.
On Wednesdays last week, he had a little bit of a kickoff there, and Milo was perfect. And hit from, you know, 47, and McKnight struggled from over 40. So is it just when the lights turn on that Milo is something?
You know what? I can't tell you that. Like I said, because if we'd have gone off of that, you would have thought it would have went that way. But like I said, when the lights came on, Brody did a good job. And like I said, the lights come on again, and preseason, regular season, postseason, they have to make the kicks. So they'll get the opportunity this week, and we'll make decisions from there.
Will Schmidt get a chance to kick?
Yeah, he'll get a chance also. He does, and we'll give him a chance also. So I want to see which one of those guys have the biggest leg and the most accurate.
Kept four quarterbacks last season. You say you're not willing to keep four this season.
Well, you know, last year is one of those things that where, you know, we had to keep four just to find a two. You know, at this point, you know, Drew stepped up tremendously. He's playing better. He has a better understanding of the CFL game. His balls are a lot, you know, he's throwing them better than he did last year. And, you know, we have faith in him as a two at this point. And, you know, I didn't think that we had to go through the thing of having four just to find two.
Is Drew locked up the backup job?
Oh, I tell you what, like I said, that's, you know how I live. So it's only locked as long as you can keep it. So locked meaning throughout the year. I think Drew is a competitor, and I think he'll do well enough to keep that position. But that's totally up to him and his preparation and execution.